Hola mi gente, welcome to episode 6 of Books and Bachata. And the goal of this podcast is to discuss life lessons learned the hard way, but mostly from books and bachata. I am your host, Ms. Malcolm Hughes, and our topic for today was inspired by my experience dancing bachata. So for those of you who don't know, I began taking bachata lessons in September of 2020. And I absolutely fell in love. I hadn't taken classes since undergrad, and just to get back into it, it was just, the flame was reignited, and I don't want to put it down. So I would say that I enjoy dancing, and I'm naturally a pretty sensual person. So it's not surprising that dancing bachata and the sensual nature of it just swept me away. From that first time I had a class in undergrad, there was a teacher that came and he chose me from the crowd to practice with him, and I just loved bachata from that moment. And I hadn't taken classes really since, maybe once every blue moon, but to be consistent, I started back in 2020. And if you haven't taken a bachata class, I highly recommend it. So, though that wasn't surprising that I fell right back in rhythm so naturally, what has been surprising with me is how the dance lessons have been transferable to my personal life, most specifically my romantic life. But before we unpack those lessons, let's set the mood with the right musical vibrations. Tune was Promise by Romeo Santos and Usher. Y'all, when Romeo says, or Romeo says, "Prométame, mami," it does something to me every single time. Okay, but let's get back to the point of the podcast, shall we? So, when you're dancing with a partner in bachata, you realize very early on how important it is that every person plays their part. For instance, I'm a strong follow. unless you're a solid and secure lead, I'm going to control the dance from the follow position. It's just going to happen. And that's not fun for me. I want to be able to submit and really just flow with the dance, right? I want to be able to release control and allow my partner to swing me, dip me, sway me in whatever manner the dance needs to progress. And the reality is, it's probably not fun for the other person. If you've decided that you want to be the lead, then chances are you enter the dance expecting that you will be able to lead and you'll have someone who will follow. The problem with that is, then you need to be secure in your position. You need to be a strong lead. You need to be able to hold your partner accordingly to be able to direct them, right? For when you want to turn them, when you want to dip them, so that you don't do damage and you don't do harm. Because if the signals that you're giving off aren't clear, then it's not going to flow smoothly. The moves are not going to flow. It's going to be choppy at best, right? And the reality is, if your partner realizes that they can't trust you to lead, whether in dance and subsequently in life, depending on the type of partner you have, it can go a few different ways, right? One way is that maybe they'll just leave. They'll politely thank you for your time, exit the dance. Another possibility is that they will submit to that, and then you'll be choppy and awkward and look insane on the dance floor. And another possibility, depending on the type of follow that you have, if you have a follow like me, and I'm trying to enjoy the dance because that's what I came out to do, to dance. If I decide to continue dancing with you and not move on, then I'm going to try to redirect. I'm going to lead, right? I'm going to lead from the follow position because I had to step up because you weren't doing what was expected of you as the lead. You either didn't know how, you were feeling insecure, not quite confident. It could be a number of factors, but what it boils down to is that you are incapable of leading us through these steps to get to the end goal of a well-executed dance. And that, for me, when I ponder on that, is just so symbolic of life and romantic relationships. Basically, if you look at everything I've said, it's completely transferable to dating. So if you have someone, you take an alpha person with someone who's maybe a beta, or you have two alphas, there has to be a solid understanding of everyone's position. And you have to be secure in that position. Okay, if you're going to lead, then I need you to be this type of lead. If you're going to follow, then I need you to be this, like I need to be this type of follow. So it goes both ways. And in reality, something that happens in dance that should happen in romance is that I should know what I'm walking into. So for instance, I actually haven't been dancing as much because I'm recovering from frozen shoulder. And it's a dance-related injury. It happened while dancing. Someone was trying to increase the velocity of a turn and they yanked my arm and it caused damage, and I'm trying to overcome that. But the reality is, what frozen shoulder does is there's all this scar tissue where it should be fluid so that I can lift my arm, bend my arm, do it all seamlessly. So with that, it's limited range of motion is one of the key side effects. So I don't have full mobility in my arm. And with that, I have to tell people when I'm going into a dance, I have to say, hey, I have a shoulder-related injury. So if you're going to turn me, like, you need to let me know, or you need to be gentle. You just need to adjust your style of leading so that you don't do more damage or do more harm. And that's just going in so that we both have set expectations for, like, hey, if you're going to turn me in this one direction, it won't be a seamless or smooth. We have to adjust for that. These conversations should also happen before you're entering relationships, right? Everyone should understand where you stand. Has there been damage done here? If so, are there injuries that remain from that? How are you treating them? How far are you in recovery? What can you withstand? Right? Like, these are conversations that need to be had beforehand, and often they don't happen. I have finally reached a point in my, I want to say, dating journey, but honestly, when you really get to the crux of it, it's within your self-worth and your self-value and your confidence and like your attachment, how secure are you? So moving away from maybe an anxious or detached attachment style, moving into something that's more secure. And with that, security within yourself or within myself, I'm able to have harder conversations. So as opposed to stringing someone along or even allowing myself to be strung along, I'm able to actually be like, hey, so what's happening here? Because this is what's happening for me. What's happening for you? Based on what I have going on in my life, this is what I can accept, right? This is what I can provide. What do you bring to the table? And that can be for a number of things, for whatever I'm looking for from that person at that time. But having those very honest and crucial and critical conversations, because what's going on in your life and what's going on in my life may not be in alignment. And I had to get to the point where I was okay with that, right? And so I think that's a big lesson from Machatha, because if I'm dancing with someone who may be a more novice dancer, and I want to do something more intricate, they may not be able to do that. So one of two things needs to happen. I need to either peel it back and meet them at their level, right? So there needs to be a compromise there. And I think that that is just transferable to our romantic relationships, because when we don't do that, we have a situation where you do damage and you can cause more harm, even if your intent is good. You may have good intentions. So same thing with my arm, right? There was no ill intent there. We were practicing executing a dance move for a dance performance. And it just so happened that they didn't understand that what they were trying to do wasn't going to work for my body. I wasn't prepared. And the speed and strength with which they were using to execute the turn, you have to be ready for that. So you have to communicate that this is what we're doing. This is what's happening. And I just really wanted to come on and share that, because I think that oftentimes we enter into relationships, whether familiar, romantic, platonic, whatever type of relationship, and we aren't as clear as we need to be on this is where I am, this is what position I can play, whether that be I want to lead, I'm this type of lead, I want to follow, I want to lead, do it this type of way, or whether or not, hey, I can lead in these areas, but I need you to lead in these areas. I want to take more of a back seat or more of a side seat in these areas. I'd like for you to step up. What are your weaknesses? What are my strengths? And we can meet each other in the middle. And that was just a lesson that I got from Bachata that I thought would be helpful. I made a strong connection immediately to my dating and romance life, and I wanted to share that with all of you. So, again, as I always say, my only true advice, it's so funny, a friend shared a meme, and it was like, there's always that one friend who gives like great advice, but then they follow it up with, it's like, but I don't know, in case it doesn't work. And she was like, that's so you. Because it's true. I would give you A1 advice. And like, but listen, at the end of the day, you're gonna do what you wanna do. So you do what you feel is right. Because we're all on our own journeys. And it's important that we trust ourselves. So like I always say, my only true advice is make choices and decisions that you can live with. Because you will be the one enduring the perks and the consequences. And that's it for me, y'all. That is our episode. I'm hoping to be more consistent. There's been so much going on with me as far as traveling. If you follow me on YouTube, and if you don't, yes, this is a plug. Go over to Miss Malcolm Hughes on YouTube. And I was traveling full time in my car. That did not go as planned. There have been changes to the plan, but I am still traveling. I am still exploring and seeing new things and delving deeper into my own soul and essence and learning more about me. And I hope that I can continue to share those stories with y'all here. So head on over to YouTube to follow the journey. More videos will be posted soon, leading up to where my next stop is and where I am right now. And until the next one, I am Ms. Malcolm Hughes. And remember that as long as you can rest well with the decisions you made at night and face yourself in the mirror each morning, none of the rest really matters. It's all chatter in the end. Peace, y'all. Adios. On level. And now we are going to head out to the tunes of a song that I really loved. Especially it was one of the anthems for my journey, the chapter that I'm in now of exploring life. And that is La Mejor Versión de Mí by Nati Natasha y Romeo Santos.
Tu manera, me olvidé hasta de serio.